Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
Risk of shoulder injury can be reduced by strengthening the small muscles that stabilize the joint. To prevent shoulder injuries, the muscles of the rotator cuff need to be strengthened as they keep the ball and socket stable through an athletic activity like throwing a ball or reaching to catch a pass. Strengthening these foundation muscles is a good way to keep your shoulders healthy and keep you on the field. If you want more injury prevention techniques, then please contact us.
One defender from Salt Lake City, number 3, Trent Herbert. He's joined by his parents, Terry and Rob Herbert. A 5'10 defenseman from Draper, Utah, number 6, Wyatt Wilson. He's joined by Michelle Wilson. A 5'10 midfielder from Annapolis, Maryland, number 17, Eric Crosby. Brennan Crosby. A 5'8 senior from Darlington, Maryland, number 25, Graham Archer. From Graham Archer. A 5'4 graduate from Salt Lake City, number 27, Joaquin Mitchell.
Westminster Basketball on Griffins TV, brought to you by our Team Griffin corporate partners, Adidas, SportsMed Utah, Park City Mountain Resort, Pepsi.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
To reduce your risk of dehydration, drink plenty of fluids. Don't wait until you feel thirsty. Drink water and sports beverages before, during, and after exercising or playing. And avoid caffeine, sugary drinks, and carbonated beverages. If you're staying hydrated but still experience fatigue or dizziness, see your doctor or contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
Tonight's game is brought to you by SportsMed Utah, the official sports medicine provider of Westminster College. No matter your injury or individual needs, their expert team is here for you. SportsMed Utah, proud supporters of Westminster Athletics.
And good afternoon, everyone. And here on a nice sunny day at Salt Lake City, Utah, for an RMLC matchup between the BYU Cougars and the Westminster Griffins. Joining me here today also is the man, myth, the legend, a fellow alumni of the lacrosse team and graduate of Westminster College, Scott Kellner. Scott, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well, Alex. I'm happy to be here, and both teams look like they're ready to play, and I'm excited to watch some great lacrosse.
Yeah, Scott, I mean, since you've played 4 years here at Westminster and you've been able to kind of watch the team grow since your graduation, you know, how excited are you for this game to, you know, see such a tight matchup of two highly ranked teams and two very closely heated rivals here in the RMLC?
Well, we've played BYU every year since 2010, so this is the fifth regular season matchup, and every year the score has been getting closer and closer. So I'm hoping that this is the first time we can Westminster could pull out the W.
Absolutely. And Scott, what do you think are a couple of key takeaways for Westminster to pull off a win against BYU?
I think really this team plays physical. Westminster is a physical team, and I think they need to continue to be physical and really almost punch BYU in the mouth right on the opening faceoff and try to get them on their heels and really control the pace of the game.
Absolutely, absolutely. And here we are with starters coming out to the field.
Looks like Eric Gronseth will be starting in the cage today. A junior out of Juan Diego High School for Westminster College.
And on the faceoff, we got number 14, Ryan Kofeld, a sophomore from West Bronza, California. Joined with them is Taylor Atchison, number 40 on the wing, and number 11, Jake Berard from Meridian, Idaho.
This should be a great matchup today, Alex. I'm excited about it.
Absolutely. I think both number 14 and 11 had a very, very strong performance against both CSU and CU in the faceoff. So I'm excited to see especially what will happen at this game. And Griffins will take possession. Number 11, Jake Berard, passing up to the errant pass. Up from BYU will recover. Number 17, Dustin Skozen. Passing off to number 9, Nick Stevens. BYU will take the air of the ball and get their right personnel on for the offense.
Yeah, some of the key matchups today. That's outside the goal.
Shot is outside the goal. But BYU will recover. But again, yeah, Scott, what do you think are some of the key matchups here today, especially for BYU?
We really got to watch out for number 6, Mike Fabrizio, a senior attackman. He's averaging 5.5 points per game. He is a leader on this field.
Absolutely. And Westminster will recover the ball after an errant pass by BYU. And number 17, Eric Crosby, up top with the ball. And drop air pass up, picked up by Troy Vance, the fit freshman And a big shot, gold by 28, Kyle Postler. It says number 15, Troy Vance. Scotty, what do you have to say about that? I mean, that's just great, you know, great recognition, and especially from a freshman from Meridian, Idaho. You know, it just goes to show how much the game's grown, and, you know, smart players aren't just coming from the East Coast anymore. They're coming from everywhere.
Westminster's brought in another great recruiting class this year. There's a lot of freshmen that are definitely stepping up and getting some big minutes this season.
Yeah, absolutely. And that will be 1-0 Westminster with 13:24 left in the first quarter. And BYU will pick it up. Number 17, Dustin Skozin. Number 14, Chandler Westcott with the ball. Running with him is freshman Tanner Durier. Pass up number 6, Mike Fabrizio. And off to 21, Jake Arbon. And a big behind-the-back shot from number 5, Alec Grant. That goes wide, but BYU will recover. Again, what do you think BYU is going to come out and start doing, Scott? It seems that BYU really wants to pick on the one-on-one matchups and try to beat their man one-on-one.
Well, that's traditionally BYU has been a ball club that handles the ball well, dodges and looks to move it and try to find gaps on the weak side. I think if the defense wants to be successful, they're going to have to play with their heads on a swivel and make sure they're not getting lost in all of the off-ball movement that BYU does.
Yeah, absolutely. Another big shot by number 5, Alec Grant. And BYU will recover the shot. And number 3, Chen Erber with the big stick check and gets the ball back for the Griffins, but it's being pressured by number 6, Mike Fabrizio. Number 14, Ryan Kofeld will take it up the fields. And Westminster will get the right personnel on the field, and while Kyle Poster takes it out. Again, another big play by number 3, Trent Herbert, especially on the senior captain for BYU, Mike Fabrizio. And that does not happen often for the senior attackman from BYU, you don't think.
Yeah, I think this is a big stage, Vinny. This is a big matchup in terms of conference seeding going into the conference tournament and obviously the national tournament. RMLC is always one of the best represented conferences in the national tournament. And I think maybe he was just being a little too casual with the ball there.
Absolutely. And number 15, Troy Vance will take the ball up and shoot, and stuffed by the goalie. Number 30, Dallin Hampshire, freshman goalie for BYU. Impressive stop for him on the doorstep. Again, number 6, Mike Fabrizio with the ball up, back up top. And shot, goal! Mike Fabrizio, BYU. Again, taking his man one-on-one, beating him up top, and a great shielded shot. It's tough for Eric Gronsef of Westminster to kind of read the shot coming in when he's using his man so well to block the shot.
Yeah, I think Trent was Trent Herbert, number 3, the senior defenseman playing number 6. Mike Fabrizio was a little overzealous. Maybe overplayed the ball a little too bit, got out of position and gave up a good shot.
Absolutely. Now it'll be 1-1 here at Dumke Field with 10:12 left in the first quarter. And number 11, Jake Berard with the pickup. Westminster will look to go on the attack. Again, Westminster looking to take some time off the clock and get the right personnel they want on the field and get the one shot they want. And 15 Troy Vance with the ball. Again, really interesting story. At number 15, number 33, two standout freshmen and two goal leaders on the team, and being great players and additions for the Westminster offense. You don't normally see that much for two freshmen to come in and, you know, be so confident with the ball handling and being able to take on juniors or seniors who've been in the league for a while. It's really interesting, especially after graduating some key players last year, like senior Colin Madsen, one of the great attackmen for Westminster. And Scott, what do you think about that?
You have to give a lot of credit to this coaching staff and really Brad Lavoie. He works really hard to recruit players that can really come in and have an impact right away. And I know that was something when you and I played, Vinny. They really structured practices, and this team was really structured so that the guys compete against one another every day. I mean, they're on a team, and there's definitely a team concept. But, what an amazing shot.
Yeah, Thomas Sargent, 33, the all-time goal leader here for Westminster this year. And an excellent diving shot, beating his man on the inside and plucking it right over the top of the goalie.
I mean, that's exactly what we were talking about, yeah. Alex. This freshman that could come in and have an impact on the game. He doesn't seem like he's afraid of this big stage. And that's really a credit to the wonderful recruiting that Westminster has done. Over the past couple of years.
You got to give credit to those upperclassmen, too. I think they really hyped up this game, you know, to make sure these freshmen and younger classmen understand this is a big deal to them. This is a big rivalry. BYU is going to come out hitting hard, wanting to take Westminster down. And, you know, after these two big wins against CSU and CU, they want to prove that Westminster, you know, may have been just kind of a fluke or something. And Mike Fabrizio will go in but lose the ball.
Recovered by number 9, Zach Stout.
Zach Stout
looking to push it in transition. Sargent with the ball. Looks to Kyle Posler.
Dropped errant pass. But Kyle Posler will recover the ball.
Now they'll look to slow it down. We have Josh Holland and Elias Fairman coming out on the field. Along with number 26, Bridger Fisher, who's another great recruit, Alex, for this freshman class.
Yeah, local Utah native, and this guy just has wheels like no other. He can, you know, run the ball wherever. He's a very confident shooter. I know back in the Minnesota Duluth game, he came out hard, playing very hard, especially for a very close game. He wasn't afraid to take shots. And another big shot, Josh Holland up top, assist by Bridger Fisher. And again, these Westminster offense, it's showing a lot of confidence on the field. They're ready to take BYU on. They don't want to lose.
Well, that's where number 5 is at his best. You put him in the middle of the field, 16-17 yards. He'll make that shot 9 out of 10 times. A very good time and room shooter.
Absolutely. And that'll be 3-1 here in the first quarter with 7:06 left. Again, number 14, Ryan Koufax at the X, facing off. And a big physical play there, but he manages to hold on to the ball. Oh, and a big rip from Thomas Sargent, but is deflected by number 32, Jacob Fulkerson. Number 36, Chris Pompoko with the ball up top. Looking to try to put the shot in, but gets deflected by number 30, Dolan Hampshire. Another big shot there from Eric Crosby, number 17, Eric Crosby on the side. And Eric Crosby, a local Maryland native. I mean, it's really interesting how big these programs have been getting, picking up a lot of players from the East Coast, recognizing MCLA is not just club ball really anymore. These programs treat it like they're NCAA.
Ever since I was on the team, Alex, we never treated this program like it was a club program. We always were coached and treated as though we were a varsity NCAA program.
Absolutely, and I recognize that programs here are getting a lot more funding from schools, and schools recognizing it's the up-and-coming sport here and the sports world. And I mean, you see it all over ESPN now, and all the Division I games are getting played, and even a lot of Division III games are getting played on big screens. And a flag will be thrown with a hold, but will be waved off. So there'll be no penalty on the play, but Griffins will retain the ball. Number 25, Graham Archer, with the ball.
One of the member of the this year's senior class, and really a terrific leader and great locker room guy, Graham Archer. Smart player, handles the ball well, and really probably helped get this team ready to go before the game today.
Yeah, absolutely. I spent some time at that. And another big shot from Kyle Foster, 28, the senior, assisted by Thomas Sargent. It's just funny to watch this. It seems like these guys have been playing for 5 or 6 years, and this is their first year playing together, and they just know how they play, and it's amazing to see how they move that ball so quickly and so effortlessly.
Well, Kyle Posler, ever since he arrived as a freshman, has always been a great off-the-ball player. And we saw it right there where he cut, curled around the crease, and was wide open for a feed, and he made sure to finish it.
Absolutely. And we'll have a timeout here, so we'll be right back after a quick word from our sponsors.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
To speed up recovery from a sprained ankle, follow the RICE treatment plan. Rest, ice, compression, and elevation. First, rest and keep weight off the ankle. Next, ice the injury for about 20 minutes at a time. Third, wrap the ankle in a compression bandage, and finally, elevate to minimize swelling. If you experience an ankle injury, see your doctor or call us.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
Proper nutrition helps athletes enhance training efforts, improve health, maintain weight, and maximize physical performance. Before and after activity, we recommend balanced nutrition, including carbohydrates, proteins, fruits, and vegetables. If you want more information on how proper nutrition can help you, see your doctor or contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
And we're back after a quick timeout here taken. The score is 4-1, Westminster with 5 minutes left in the first quarter. That would be a number 11, Jake Breyer, taking the faceoff.
His nickname, Alex, is Meaty.
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 Given that kid's, he's a big man, one of the leading guys in the weight room. It was a Wishbone QB, actually, from Meridian, Idaho, being actually recruited by a couple places for a quarterback role, but decided to come play lacrosse here at Westminster. And again, it's another thing that goes to show. Looks like some kids just really like to play lacrosse. And number 39 will take a step out of bounds. Westminster number 9, Zach Stout, will take the ball. Now Zach Stout, another great addition here, went off on his mission in Finland and came back here to continue playing lacrosse after joining the ROTC program here.
Zach Stout was one of my senior year, Zach Stout was a freshman, and he was one of my favorite freshmen on the team, Alex.
Absolutely. And as per request by Zach Stout, he'd like to give out a shout-out to his friend Ryan Gold out of Finland. Ryan, I hope you're having a good time watching the game out there in Europe with all your fellow Finnish friends.
Ground ball, Joaquin Mixco.
Again, this seems like the Westminster Ride is giving some trouble here to BYU. They haven't been able to come and take a, you know, stable offensive set here for a while now. Number 5, Josh Holland with the ball up top.
Looking to set up the offense.
Number Again, number 22 with the ball, Elias Fairman.
Tremendous athlete, Alex. Really, probably one of the highest caliber athletes on the field between both teams.
Absolutely. And business management major here, and he's actually planning to go join the Marines after graduating. I think he has a lot of inspiration from one of his closest friends who is also serving in the Air Force. And a big missed pass here, but Griffin still will recover. And Elias Fairman trying to take the shot will get checked, and BYU will recover. Number 32, Jacob Fulkerson, will take the ball down and pass it off to number 2, Jack Fabrizio, younger brother of Mike Fabrizio. Again, BYU moving the ball up top. Number 21, Jake Arbon with the ball. Move it to number 9, Nick Stevens. Number 14, Chandler Westcott, moving the ball while getting some nasty stick checks by another freshman, 35, Tanner Duryea.
Yeah, Chandler Westcott, another points leader with his BYU team. He is another number 14. He is someone to watch out for. He can do damage.
Absolutely. It seems like Tanner Duryea, though, the freshman from a local, another local Utah native, winning the D2 state championship last year. He's been a very impressive performer here, even in earning a starting spot in a very senior-heavy defense. And BYU will continue to move the ball, picking on those one-on-one matchups. Jake Arbon. Trying to make something happen for his team, and shoots and will score. Jack Arbon, number 21 for BYU, will work his man in the middle and get an open, nice shot here. It's a tough stop there for Eric Gronseth. It's those point blank ones are just super hard to read, especially when they have so much angle on the goal.
Yeah, it looked like he read a little bit too much into it, Alex. His stick was in the right place, and it was a little bit of a change up shot, and he kind of just moved right out of the way.
Yeah,
he wishes, he knows he should have had that one.
Yeah, it's one of those tough shots. But again, the score is 4-2 now. Westminster with 1 minute left in the first quarter. Number 14, Ryan Kofelt, and number 17, Dustin Skuzin, battling out here on the X. But BYU will recover and take the ball on offense. Big stick jet there from the number 31, the senior defenseman, Spencer Huso. And Mike Fabrizio will take a shot, and it will hit pipe after dodging through two Westminster defenders. Number 1, Zach Jordan will take a shot, and it will go high. Might have been a lucky break there for Westminster after the slide was missed and hitting his own guy, and point-blank shot, but hits pipe.
Well, I think.
And another big shot. Zach Jordan taking his man down the field and just nice right-hand shot.
You know, I haven't been impressed with the ball movement really by BYU. So far, they've scored by one-on-one matchups, isolation moves, and really just being dodging to the goal and being physical with their dodges.
Absolutely, and I think it's just been they've been getting the right shots though, and they've been getting the right angles on Eric Gronseth, making those shots. But we'll see. We still got a long ball game ahead. And the score will be 4-3. Westminster still up by 1. And BYU will be called for a false start. Westminster will pick it up. Number 28, Kyle Possler. We'll look to move the ball, but the quarter will end with 4-3. Westminster up by 1 going into the second quarter. Stay tuned, and we'll be back after a few short messages from our sponsors.
We'll be right back.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
Prevent injury and reduce knee pain by strengthening the muscles surrounding the joint. Strong muscles are your first line of protection. Start a program that gradually increases strength and conditioning to help protect the knee joints. And incorporate drills specific to your sport to keep you in game shape. If you experience a knee injury, see your doctor or contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
Tonight's game is brought to you by Park City Mountain Resort, the official training partner of the Westminster Ski and Snowboard Team. Park City Mountain Resort, discover your mountain.
And we're back here, the second quarter of another big RMLC matchup between the BYU Cougars and Westminster College Griffins. The score is 4-3, Westminster up by one. Scott, what do you think Westminster needs to do to take it into the half with winning points?
Well, I think Westminster so far has done a good job when the ball is on the offensive end. I've always been a big believer in that the best defense is a good offense that can hold the ball.
Absolutely.
And I think BYU has shown that they could score. They could take the one-on-one matchups. And I'd like to see Westminster maybe possess the ball and work it a little bit more and get some high-quality shots.
Absolutely. And for BYU, what do you think BYU needs to do to try and put some pressure on Westminster?
Well, I think right now Westminster's coming up with a lot of the 50-50 ground balls. They didn't come up with that one right there. And so really just be more physical in transition and kind of have more of a sense of urgency in transition and with ground balls. And, that could kind of even the tide, I guess, for BYU.
Absolutely. And number 9 here, Nick Stevens here with the ball for BYU. Looking to take a shot, just goes wide of the cage. Number 6, Mike Fabrizio, will take the ball from behind.
My fellow alumni saying hello to Alex Vincent and I on the side there.
Yeah, an absolutely packed crowd here today at Dumpke Field. I mean, for a major RMLC matchup, it's great to see that all the fans here for both schools and both places will come out and watch. And it's good to see that the out west here, the fan base and the the overall visibility of the sport's growing every day. And number 9 will take a shot. It's Nick Stevens. With the assist, number 29, Chase Miller. Again, another big shot here outside. It seems like Eric Gronseth here in cage is having a tough time stopping those outside shots.
Well, that was really, Eric Gronseth has been getting off to slow starts in recent games recently, but the defense really seemed like they were not prepared for the inbounds on that play right there. They were flat-footed and weren't ready. There was not a defender with anywhere near number 9, Nick Stevens, when he took that shot.
Absolutely. And it seems that BYU will pick up the ball off the faceoff. Number 17, Dustin Skozin. Mike Fabrizio, number 6, with the ball, driving in. And a big shot score from Mike Fabrizio, the senior captain for BYU. And it seems that a little scuffle here on the field after a little bit of a late hit. But again, another good, a very good recognition there from Mike Fabrizio, the senior captain. I believe there was no slide there on him, and it was just a very tough shot to stop for Eric Gronseth when it's just a one-on-one matchup.
Yeah, I think the Westminster defense really needs to make sure if Trent Herbert is going to pressure number 6 that hard on the perimeter, they need to make sure that they have a slide ready to go, because Mike Fabrizio is good enough to beat you one-on-one if you pressure him out there on the perimeter.
Absolutely. And the score is 5-4. BYU taking the lead with 13:28 left in the second quarter. Again, number 14, Ryan Kofelt on the X, playing against number 22, Josh Tunick. And number 14, Ryan Kofelt, will pick up the ball for Westminster, and Westminster will go on the offensive.
Let's see if we can run a little time off the clock here, Alex, and try to control the tempo of this game.
Absolutely. I think here the key is for Westminster's offense to not get anxious, especially after this quick turnaround. I mean, this game is a game of runs, people can go off on a couple score screech, but again, it can be taken off really quickly. And I think, especially for a young offense here with, you know, two freshman attackmen starting, the key here is to not be too anxious and just get the right opportunities and the right shots. Number 17, Eric Crosby with the ball up top.
I like the ball movement right there, Alex.
Absolutely, yeah. Westminster doing a great job trying to find the open man, being a very selfless team here, looking for that next one.
Nice alley dodge there from senior Graham Archer.
And a big shot from number 28, Kyle Posser, just goes wide.
That's the kind of ball movement I like to see.
Absolutely. I think Westminster's doing a great job sending cutters in, really helping the teammates out, not putting all the whole load on one player or the one-on-ones, but as a team, as a whole, running together. Number 33, Thomas Sargent with the ball behind. And a big shot up top from Thomas Sargent. And he will recover the ball.
Number 4, Dylan Check, sophomore out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Passes back to number 17, Eric Crosby.
Yeah, another great addition to the team, number 4. Really quick, very quick midi. Really good at getting back in transition on both sides of the field. He's, you know, he's one of those key players that really can help stabilize the defense when, especially on errant passes such as this. He's able to get back very quickly. And both be new call recently added. I don't think I was playing with this role when I was here. And Scott, I don't know if you did, but now the new rule is that if the ball comes back on the offense and rolls back, kind of like basketball, there's the new over and back rule where the ball will get transferred over to the other team.
Well, I feel like, Alex, especially since you and I played, there's definitely been rules.
And another big score there from number 21, Jake Arbon, taking his man one-on-one. Again, just good recognition from BYU to take the man one-on-one, and they're having trouble here. Number 4 getting a little bit mouthy here with one of the refs. Again, BYU really turning off the pressure here on that defense, really pressuring them out, especially when they're not running these quick slides.
Yeah, I'm really surprised, Alex. I did not think that BYU had so many players that were so good on one-on-one situations. And so far, that's been the story of this first, I guess, 20 minutes of the game has been BYU taking the ball one-on-one.
Absolutely. And the score is 6-4 BYU. It's BYU up by 2 with 10:46 left in the game. But another big pickup from Jake Berard, sophomore from Meridian, Idaho. And he will look to pass it off, but just missed. Thomas Sargent with the recovery. And a big shot and goal from Thomas Sargent, taking his man out one-on-one. Man, what a great recognition. It almost looked like a little bit of a change-up shot there. I don't think number 30, Dallin Hampshire, was expecting kind of a soft shot going down below. Again, another big shot here for the Griffins to bring it back up, only behind by one now with 10:29 left in the game.
Well, I loved number 33, Thomas Sargent's recognition right there, knowing that he was being pressured on the perimeter, not seeing a slide, and going hard to the cage.
Yeah, that's even, you know, as a freshman, it's hard to believe that a freshman would come in with that, you know, great of mindset and just recognition to come in and do something like that.
We got a flag down on the field. Zach Stout gets the ball to the attack.
This will be a free possession here for the Griffins. They'll look to take the timeout and get the shot they want. Number 5, Josh Holland with the ball up top. Josh Holland looking to take his guy one-on-one. Josh Holland, another big D2 transfer off of Seton Hall. Coming in back to his hometown to play for the Westminster Griffins. Another great recruiting addition here through Westminster.
Well, it's always good to see transfers coming in, Alex. It means those players respect and believe in the program and really believe that Westminster is a better program than where they were. And that's always great to see, is having good transfers coming in.
Absolutely, and again, that just brings more visibility here for both teams and the sport in general, recognizing that some of the best players now are coming to the MCLA and to teams that are more local to their college instead of having to fly out all the way to the East Coast.
Nice.
And another big goal here. 33 with the assist, number 15, Troy Vance, the freshman and the freshman combo. Again, what a great recognition. Thomas Sargent drawing an extra man, and Troy Vance gained that cut in. What a just picture-perfect execution there.
Yeah, I think this Westminster coaching staff is pretty excited about those two guys playing together for a full 4 years.
Absolutely, absolutely, especially with the hints of Westminster going NCAA. I think both Brad Lavoie and Mason Goodhand are very excited to have these kind of two additions. Show that, try to get other players here to recognize, you know, some of the top players in the local West area are coming out for Westminster. And the score will be tied here, 6-6 with 9:14 left in the second quarter. Again, BYU with the pickup, number 17, Dustin Skuzin. Ball will be moved back behind. Back to number 9, Nick Stevens. And back to number 1, Zach Jordan. Number 29 with the big wide shot. Seems to take a ricochet and right bounce right back. Westminster getting physical there, pushing the man out of bounds and taking the ball back. And going back to your point, Scott, so the physicality of Westminster has just skyrocketed in these past few years.
It really has. It's been something that has been a point of emphasis since you and I were on the team. I graduated in 2012, and really a lot of it has to do with the work that these guys do in the weight room.
Absolutely. And a timeout has been taken. We will be right back with a quick word from our sponsors.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the Red Line Downtown Salt Lake City, an official lodging partner of Westminster Athletics. The Red Line Downtown, a short distance to world-class skiing.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
Muscle cramps are painful and can happen during activity when dehydrated and fatigued. Depending on the location of the cramp, stretch, massage, and immediately hydrate with drinks including electrolytes. If the cramping continues, stop activity and see your doctor or contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
And we're back here. Westminster with the ball off to the side with 8:17 left in the second quarter. Elias Fairman, number 22, star standout here, junior from local area, from Brighton, Utah. We'll move the ball to Eric Crosby, number 17. And big shot there for Westminster. Number 28, Kyle Posler with the shot. Number 15, Troy Vance with the assist. I mean, great ball start. It started all out with Elias Fairman drawing two other guys on him, simply moving the ball, getting it behind, and Westminster recognizing where the open man is and just moving that ball so seamlessly, getting that excellent shot from Kyle Posler. And that's Kyle Posler's bread and butter right there.
That really is, Alex. You know, he's a great off-ball player. He was able to get open and find the space and put in a nice time and room shot.
Absolutely. Left hand, top right, or top left corner. And BYU will be called for illegal procedure, so it will be Westminster's ball. And Again, Westminster up by one, 7-6, with 7:37 left in the ball game, or left in the second quarter. Again, Elias Fairman dodging, trying to get his man to draw. But number 33 will throw it straight into the defender's stick, and BYU will recover.
That was maybe where some of this freshman attack was showing their age, Alex.
Yeah.
Sergeant wasn't moving his feet with that pass. It was easy for his defender to knock it down.
Absolutely, and just recognizing, too, that those are really tough passes to throw behind cage with all those sticks up in the air. And number 10, Chase Miller with the ball.
Nice throw, Chase.
Big shot, but is stripped from Eric Crosby. Again, Eric Crosby with the gamble there. Chooses to leave his man and go for the behind the back, or the kind of loose stick check there. Letting his big catch there from Josh Hall, number 5.
Wow, he's fast.
Absolutely, and a big shot though, but stopped by number 30, Dallin Hampshire. Yeah, and another big shot. Kyle Posser having a great day so far.
I believe that's his fourth goal, Alex.
Absolutely. Kyle's he just seems to be in the right place at the right time. Given that senior status, he knows where to be at the right time and get those shots he loves to take, those left sidearm rips.
I know Kyle came into today with 21 goals on the season. Maybe he can, he has 4 in the first half so far. Maybe he can have 30 by the end of the day.
Yeah, maybe. We'll see. Again, that will make it 8-6 Westminster back up 2 with 6:05 left in the game, or left in the second quarter. Apologies. Number 14, Ryan Kofout, battling out with number 17, Dustin Skuzin. And the ball will be turned back over to BYU. Number 21, Jake Arbon with the ball, moving it. Number 5, Alec Grant, trying to test his man, the young sophomore from Westminster. And number 11, Jaden Hawes with the shot and goal. Looks like Westminster there was getting caught up in their defense there, in the rotation. Seems that they slid hard but failed to get back into their number situation. And again, it's just BYU taking great recognition, forcing those players to rotate, getting them confused, and getting the right shots they need.
Well, that's what can happen, Alex, when you move the ball with intention or with authority. Defenses can get caught ball watching.
Absolutely.
And that's what happened right there.
Again, the score will be 8-7. Westminster still up by 1 with 5 minutes left in the second quarter. BYU with the pickup by number 4, Max Nesser. And number 6, Mike Fabrizio on behind, getting his defender caught on the crease. I mean, this is kind of those situations Westminster's defense do not want to be stuck in, especially with a quick attackman such as Mike Fabrizio.
Yeah, a lot of offenses relish this opportunity, Alex.
Big shot by Mike Fabrizio, but hits pipe. A big shot up high by Alec Grant, missing far up high, but BYU will recover. Number 14, Chandler Westcott with the ball, moving it to number 5. Alec Grant. Oh, and another big shot up high. Alec Grant seems to have a cannon, but is having difficulty putting it on cage. Number 6, Mike Fabrizio with the ball behind.
I like the patience that BYU is playing with right now. they're really working to make sure they get a good shot.
And a big save by Eric Ronseth on the doorstep. Shot off number 14, Chandler Westcott. Yeah, Scott, just going off your point, too. BYU taking the time and wearing down the defense right there. Number 21, Jake Arbon with the shot goal. Again, they found that opportunity, taking the time, you know, working their defenders, getting them a little bit tired, getting them caught ball watching, and they're taking these nice shots that they want to take.
Well, I think right there, Alex, the defense had slid over to protect the right side of the field. Left number, I think that was 14 with the shot. Who scored? 14. Left number 14 on the island. They moved it over to the weak side, and he took his man and was able to put one away.
And that will be all tied up now in the second quarter, 8-all. And it's a foot race after the ball. Ryan Kofelt battling it out here. And number 38 will step out of bounds. We'll give the ball back to Westminster. Again, great job by the faceoff team there, just giving it their all and not stopping. And lo and behold, the BYU makes a mistake, giving the ball back to Westminster.
Well, I love the peskiness that Westminster is playing with on the ground balls. They're really not making it easy for BYU to pick those up.
Absolutely not. Yeah, again, Mason Goodhand, one of his, you know, key philosophies is the battle on the ground for those ground balls. He really stresses the point that ground balls are everything in this game, gives you everything you need to win a game. And a big shot by number 17, Eric Crosby. What a play right there. 28 with the dodge, moving it with a seamless pass through defenders, and Crosby with the time and room shot. Again, just excellent ball movement on Westminster.
Yeah, that's one of their go-to sets, Alex. It's a 1-4-1 set with a isolation from up top. One of the crease men curls out around on the far side, and you can get good looks like that.
Absolutely, and just a perfect shot there. Westminster takes the lead, 9-8, with 2:59 left in the first half. And number 11, Jake Berard with the pickup. But will be turned back over for BYU.
I didn't see the call there, Alex, but I don't think the crowd agrees with it.
Absolutely no. But number 35, Tanner Duryea, will be called with a push from behind. And ball will go to BYU. Okay, number 6, Mike Fafrizio with the ball from behind. And a big shot there from Mike Fabrizio, being his man one-on-one. Again, seems that BYU is taking their defenders way up top and letting Mike Fabrizio run all over the place. This is a tough day for number 3, Trent Herbert.
Westminster defense huddled up right now. I hope they're talking about how they're going to handle number 6 and hopefully sending a slide early.
Absolutely.
Really, number 3, Trent Herbert, should be turning him back into the crease. Right now, number 6 just beating Trent right over the top, and really defenses are trained or coached to not let that happen.
Absolutely. And it's all tied up here, 9-all with 2:24 left in the half. But a flag is thrown. 27 will be called with the penalty with a 1 minute slash. So this will be the first time for Westminster to go man up. Again, Josh Holland up top with the ball. And a big shot for number 22, Elias Fairman, but it's stopped. So BYU will look to kill the penalty. And the ball is stripped loose by Elias Fairman. Number four having a tough time trying to clear the ball, being double teamed. And another big check there. But BYU called the timeout with possession, so BYU will have possession with 1:38 left in the half. We'll take a quick short break here after a word from our sponsors.
Tonight's game is brought to you by The Courtyard by Marriott, an official lodging partner of Westminster Athletics. Courtyard by Marriott, ideal for travelers.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
A concussion occurs when any kind of force causes the brain to move back and forth. You don't need to lose consciousness to have had a concussion. Symptoms include headache, dizziness, difficulty concentrating, balance problems, and nausea. If these symptoms occur, stop activity until cleared by a healthcare professional. The smart plan for concussions is, when in doubt, hold them out.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
To reduce your risk of dehydration, drink plenty of fluids. Don't wait until you feel thirsty. Drink water and sports beverages before, during, and after exercising or playing. And avoid caffeine, sugary drinks, and carbonated beverages. If you're staying hydrated but still experience fatigue or dizziness, see your doctor or contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
And we're back here, folks, with 1:38 left in the second half. BYU will start with the ball here. Again, I think BYU going to use all that time to try and get another goal off to take the lead into half. BYU still a man down, so Westminster will double the ball. But the penalty will be called, and Westminster will not be man up. BYU returning to full strength. Number 21, Jake Arbon with the ball, looking to pressure his man inside. And a big stop. Doorstep save by number 21, Eric Gronseth. But a costly missed pass there. Number 9 just missing the pass. So BYU will have the ball here for the next 50 seconds. If Westminster cannot turn the ball over.
Real quickly, Alex, I just want to thank all of our viewers who are watching via the webcast. Your support for both Westminster College and BYU is greatly appreciated.
Absolutely.
And of course, tremendous support here at the game today.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, a lot of fans here. It's a full stadium here at Duncan Field. A lot of fans from both sides, and a lot of fans from BYU making the drive up from Provo. And a shot and goal, but a penalty is thrown, and the refs will call it a goal.
9 seconds left here in the second quarter. Eric Gronseth not happy.
Yeah, looking a bit frustrated here. I think Eric Gronseth's really not happy with the defense letting those guys in so close to him. Making it really tough for Eric to make these doorstep saves.
There must be 1,000 people in attendance here, Alex.
But I wouldn't be surprised, absolutely. And it's overfilled so much that not even everyone could get in the stands. They're having to sit on the sides of the field or stand.
That may or may not be a fire hazard, Alex.
Again, goes to show that Brad LaVoy really wanted to make Westminster men's lacrosse the flagship program here. And loose call here, 14 with the ball with 2 seconds left. On a big shot and a save from BYU.
That was a great last second opportunity though, Alex. I wish Westminster could have capitalized on that.
Absolutely, and that will be the half. BYU up 10-9. And stay tuned here, folks. We'll have an interview here with the athletic director of Westminster College, Shay Wyatt. And we'll be back with you after a short message from our sponsors.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
Risk of shoulder injury can be reduced by strengthening the small muscles that stabilize the joint. To prevent shoulder injuries, the muscles of the rotator cuff need to be strengthened as they keep the ball and socket stable through an athletic activity like throwing a ball or reaching to catch a pass. Strengthening these foundation muscles is a good way to keep your shoulders healthy and keep you on the field. If you want more injury prevention techniques, then please contact us.
Hello, folks. Thanks for tuning in here for the halftime report. Here we invited our athletic director for Westminster College, Shea Wyatt. Shea, thanks for coming out, and crazy game so far. What do you have thoughts about it?
My pleasure. Well, I'll be honest with you. It's about what I expected. So two quality teams, just both playing really hard. Our guys are playing good. It's just back and forth. I think that's what we're in store for the second half. It's going to come down to probably those last couple minutes and see who's able to finish. So Absolutely. Hopefully the Griffins prevail.
Absolutely. Shay, just a quick question. I know there's been some hype around Westminster going on to the NCAA. Where are we at the application process for Westminster?
So the institution submitted application for NCAA Division II in February.
Okay.
So it goes to a committee, and there's a lot of steps of the process, and so our application will be reviewed. And then a decision will be made in July if we're accepted into the process. The process with the NCAA Division II, it's a minimum 3-year process, so there's steps along the way. We've got to be invited to each step of the process. So we're hopeful that this coming July that we have favorable news and we can begin that.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Has there, the athletic programs at Westminster, I mean, it's not just lacrosse, right? I mean, there's a lot of athletic programs here. Women's basketball is doing very well. I mean, what's going on with some of the other athletic programs?
Yeah, so it's been a really fun year. If I start from fall to winter, we had some outstanding seasons. You know, women's soccer was conference champions. Men's soccer did extremely well. Cross country and track are doing very well throughout the year. Women's basketball, as you mentioned, Scott, they ended up ranked 5th in the country, and so they had a tremendous season, conference champions again, tournament champions. Just this past week, our women's golf team was conference champions, so that was very exciting. We were able to get that, so they've got, I think, one or two more tournaments left, so see they've got the conference tournament, actually, and see if either one of them can qualify for nationals, which would be very exciting. And just so we've really had some outstanding accomplishments by our student athletes and our teams. So, and then obviously our men's and women's lacrosse teams are having some outstanding seasons. Women lost a real tough one earlier today by 1 point, but they played extremely well. Very proud of them.
Absolutely. And Shay, what is that overall, the success is really due for the marketing of Westminster and the overall with recruitment and just the overall visibility of the school?
Well, it's been exciting. I mean, you know, our program, certainly, meaning the athletic program, we certainly haven't arrived, but we've made tremendous strides over the years. We certainly, you know, our mission, our goal, I mean, we're here to complement the institution and to provide, you know, positive experiences for our student athletes, and that's part of our programming. And the exciting thing is we've got outstanding staff. We've got coaches that work hard. You know, in my time here, we've been fortunate. We've got outstanding student athletes, and, you know, we strive every day as a staff to really make sure that we're providing positive experiences for them. Are we perfect? No. Do we continue to address things that need to be addressed? But I think we're on the right path, and we've certainly got greater goals and aspirations ahead for this program, and so we'll just keep working at it.
Absolutely. That sounds great, Scott. Shay, thank you again. For game today, especially with, I think that's one of the questions I always have when I was looking at all these fans, how do you go about preparing for such a huge deal? It's such a key to conference game.
Yeah, this is a fantastic turnout. You know, fortunately, the weather was in our favor, and
Absolutely. It's
a good draw for both teams. But it does. I mean, our staff, and we prepare for events coming up. You know, we host on campus, at least with athletics, we host over 100 athletic events per year.
Wow.
So every, you know, week and month, we're always forecasting, and kind of we have a pretty good sense of kind of what the capacity will be and kind of what the turnout might be. So we want to make sure that we're covering all bases. And that hopefully, if we're doing everything right, that nobody sees the behind-the-scenes things that sometimes come up.
Yeah.
But this is really good, and hopefully we really try to make it an event-type atmosphere, which I think today we can say that certainly is. So I think the fans are getting their money's worth, which is a good thing.
Absolutely.
What's the plan? We're doing a scholarship golf tournament again this summer.
Yeah, yep. So we do. We got the annual Westminster College golf tournament. It's June 5th at the Jeremy Ranch Golf and Country Club, which, you know, obviously up in the Park City area is a beautiful course. Proceeds of the event, we did it last year. The college has done it a number of times. Proceeds of the event go towards our athletic scholarship fund. So we're thrilled about that. We've got some information on our website, so we encourage those, if there's alums or fans or friends of the program, to sign up for that and come out and join us for a fun-filled day of golf and food and fun. And, you know, the past few years we've been doing it, it's just been a fantastic event. So we encourage people to come out and support it.
Absolutely. That sounds like a fun event there. Try to get back at my golf game there.
There we go. You and me you and me both.
Yeah, absolutely. I got to get back on the driving range for that.
That's right. That's right.
Shay, overall, this past couple 4 to 5 years, what have you really seen the progression for the men's lacrosse team? What has been your viewpoint on that? I mean, it's a relatively young, new program here.
It is. It is. I mean, arguably, it's one of our emerging programs, if you will. I mean, in terms of the years since they've been established, and I don't say that because they've had great success. So when I say that, you know, Coach Goodhand might get mad. No, maybe, but he knows what I mean. I mean, it's in terms of years with other programs, but they've done tremendous. It's been fun to watch the growth of that program. It's been fun to watch their success. And as they've moved up, whether it be in division, whether it be in affiliation, you know, it's been fantastic. You know, you guys know, you've watched the program, but the nice thing is I just think each year they've added another element. Each year the quality, and I mean, and that's not to take anything away from the guys that played before, because we've had some outstanding players, but you see, as you're trying to build a program, you're just trying to build that depth in the program and the quality of the opponent. And, you know, that's what's been really fun, is you see the quality of the opponent and our program's ability to compete. And certainly they've gotten traction and credibility, and their name has grown and the program has grown to where more people are aware of them. And that's really what we're trying to do with the college as a whole. So they certainly play a part in that.
Real quick, Shay, I think we got 60 seconds until this halftime ends, but what do you think the attendance number is for today's game?
You know, that's a good question. Well, Dumpke, I think we've estimated seats about 1,500, so I think, you know, I'll let you guys help me be the judge, think we're at capacity, and I think it's safe to say we're standing room only, so that's a good problem to have. So, yeah, after I get off this interview, I got to go down and get that crowd in some different areas. But this is good. So hopefully everybody's enjoying their time today. We appreciate everybody coming out.
Okay, well, Shay, thank you so much for spending
absolutely.
The time.
Thanks, guys.
Jay, appreciate it.
Appreciate it.
Go Griffins, right?
Okay, go Griffins. Griffins. Thanks.
Tonight's game is brought to you by SportsMed Utah, the official sports medicine provider of Westminster College. No matter your injury or individual needs, their expert team is here for you. SportsMed Utah, proud supporters of Westminster Athletics.
And we're back here for the second half in another great RMLC matchup here between the BYU Cougars and Westminster Griffins. Scott, what do you think going into the second half needs to be key here for Westminster to take home the win?
Well, I think, Alex, overall, Westminster's played a solid game. They've had some mental slip-ups or some mental lapses sometimes on the defensive end of the field. And really, I hope the coaching staff made some good adjustments and hopefully get some slides going early on senior attackman for BYU, Mike Fabrizio.
Absolutely. And what do you think BYU needs to do to continue this pressure on the Westminster defense?
Well, you know, I think they're dodging a score right now, Alex. They are dodging to shoot, and I think that's really been the key to their success is dodging to looking to score, and if they keep doing that, we could have a close game on our hands.
Absolutely. Ball up top here with Zach Jordan. Looking to take his LSM here on a one-on-one. Number 21, Chase Miller with the ball, moving it. And a big shot here from Zach Jordan, just goes wide. Number 9, moving it to number 29, Chase Miller. And ball goes to the back. to Mike Fabrizio.
There's that slide we were talking about, Chris. Alex, excuse me.
Absolutely. It seems that Westminster has switched up the personnel here. Number 35, Tanner Duryea, the freshman, will be guarding. Gosh. And a big shot and goal from number 29, Chase Miller.
Well, that's the problem with sliding, Alex, is once a slide goes, the defender who was burned or beat needs to recover and find a man.
Yeah, absolutely.
And right there were two guys chasing the ball for a little too long, and they were able to find an open guy streaking down the middle.
Absolutely. It's this Westminster offensive rotation or defensive rotation is kind of struggling on getting back onto their men overall. And again, now BYU up 11-9 here with 13:55 left in the third quarter. And a big scrum here for the ball. And a big pickup here. It seems that Westminster was looking for a call, but didn't get anything. Number 35, Tanner Duryea, is fighting on two BYU players. But BYU will pick up the ball. Number 2, Jack Fabrizio. And a one-on-one opportunity here for number 9, Nick Stevens. Shot scored. Again, Westminster, after that scrum, are having troubles trying to get back under the men.
Well, you know, unsettled situations, Alex. If you're playing against a team like BYU that's has good stick skills, high LAX IQ players, you need to be disciplined and play with a sense of urgency in unsettled situations. You can't have any mental lapses.
Absolutely.
In times like that.
Yeah, absolutely. And now the score is 12-9 BYU.
See if Westminster can control the ball and maybe go on a little run here.
Absolutely. I think it's going to, the key here is to control the ball on the offense and give their defense a break. Westminster's defense is looking a little bit tired, especially after all this, you know, trying to get in rotations and settle back in. I mean, Westminster overall and their offense is doing a great job on their settled offense and getting the right looks. Number 17, Eric Crosby, throwing it behind to number 15, Troy Vance. And moves back with the screen and pick. And a big shot score from Kyle Possler after the two-man game behind. Troy Vance, you know, getting that dodge in, being a threat on the field, drawing the slide, and a simple little grenade as they start throwing in that grenade to Kyle Possler, and Kyle Possler driving up to his favorite left-hand spot, getting that shot in.
Well, yeah, like you said, Alex, great recognition by Troy Vance to realize that Kyle had the matchup there, and good recognition by Kyle to realize that he had a lane and in space to go to the cage, so happy he could curl around and finish there.
Absolutely. And again, Westminster is still down by 2, but the score is 12-10 with 12:22 left in the game. And it seems like a BYU player trips up, and Westminster, Zach Stout, pulls up the ball. Again, yeah, it's going to come down to those faceoffs here. If Westminster can control those faceoffs and get the ball to their offense, and a big there. Seems that either overthrew that or the defender got a stick check on there in the last minute, giving that a hard pass to make.
Let's see how Westminster does on the right here, Alex. They really need to get this ball back if they want to control the tempo of this game.
Absolutely.
And there should have been somebody on that guy.
Yeah, 21, Gavin, the easy Jake Arbon just kind of cutting through the, seems to be a mix-up on the right there.
Yeah.
And number 21 trying to drive in here, forcing Westminster to rotate.
And good one-on-one defense there by Sam Bryan.
Yeah, absolutely. The San Diego native. He's a great athletic player. Really good on his feet, light on his feet. He doesn't really get beat often. He's really good. He's a football star back in high school. again, looking to have some big day out of him today.
He's really a team guy, Alex. He's played a lot of different positions on the field. He always steps up and do whatever coaches ask.
Absolutely, yeah. He's a grinder, as we put it. You know, he just is willing to do whatever it takes to get out there and help the team. And drop ball here. Big play by Joaquin Mixco, the super senior defenseman.
Yeah, I believe Joaquin Mixco is in the Masters of Communications program now here at Westminster and playing in his fourth year of eligibility.
Absolutely, and a big hit there across field from BYU against Sam Bryan. Again, Sam Bryan was getting caught in his dodge, and you know the BYU defender there got a good hit on him right when he was starting his dodge, and feet got mixed up. But BYU will retain the ball on offense. Number one, Zach Jordan with the ball.
Yeah, some of Sam Bryan's senior thoughts are, it's been a long time coming. Hope to see the fruit of the labor in regards to this matchup versus BYU.
Absolutely, you know, Sam being here, four-year player here. You know, it's been a tough road here against BYU. It's been some really hard-fought games, but always going into BYU's favor. I think he's really wanting to see a big win today against them. And
it's outside.
Number nine, Nick Stevens with the shot, but yes, it went outside. And a big shot from number 29, Chase Miller. Number two, Jack Fabrizio with the ball behind against Joaquin Mixco. And he has stepped in the crease, so the ball will go back to Westminster. I mean, great defensive set there from Joaquin Mixco. Really one of the heart and souls of the defensive side of Westminster.
Westminster has to clear the ball here, Alex.
Absolutely. I think is one of the keys here is if they can really get the ball moving to the offensive side. And great recognition by Kyle Posler. BYU trying to lock off any kind of attempts, forcing the goalie to move. Again, big round ball there, going back into Westminster's favor. Number five, Josh Holland with the ball. Big dodge up top. Moving to 22, Elias Fairman. Moving to 26, Bridger Fisher, freshman here from Utah. And a big stop there.
I thought Kyle Posler was going to get his sixth goal of the day right there, Alex.
Absolutely. And Westminster will pick up the ball. Kyle Posler is slow to get up. Looks like it was a late hit there on Kyle Posler. Running off here to the sideline. Number 20, Christian Camper, will come and take his spot. Christian from Poway, California. Another excellent addition here for the recruiting class of Westminster. Just a big physical attack, man. Again, great clear there by BYU.
BYU really being patient with the clears and making sure that they're clearing 10 for 10 times, Alex.
Absolutely, yeah. Trying to take advantage of that. And you know, they have a lot of time on that field when they're clearing. Again, 7 minutes, 18 seconds left in the third quarter. And a big stop here from 21, Eric Ronseth. Fadeaway shot from 21 on BYU. Jake Arbon gets stopped. A great job there from the freshman Tanner Duryea to move the ball. And a big hit from BYU, number 11, Jaden Hawes. and gets the recovery, but will throw it away. Getting a little bit overconfident after the big hit, will throw the ball away. Again, physicality in this game, especially for a close matchup, it's just, yeah, it's going up. There's going to be a lot of big hits coming up in these next two quarters. Eric Crosby on the side looking to work his man. And a big shot from Eric Crosby. Is that a shovel shot I saw? Holy cow.
Yeah, that was just beautiful. Behind the, kind of a Canadian flick shot. Very popular to see if you're a fan of D1 NCAA lacrosse, reminiscent of the Thompson brothers.
Absolutely, yeah.
Lyle and Miles. And
again, that Eric Crosby, great recognition. He was in the CU and CSU game. He played really key role in doing the exact same thing, just pressurizing the man, you know, bumping him down, trying to get at least a couple inches near the goal, and he would just whip it around, not caring who's around, just trying to get that goal in.
The thing I love about Crosby's game is he might not be a dominant Dodger, but he is great at probing the defense in situations just like that.
Yeah.
If you're not going to play him, he'll make you pay.
Absolutely. And a great stick pickup there by Taylor Atchison, 40. Recent switch from offensive midfielder to LSM, and he's really to embrace the whole role and become a really dominant LSM here for Westminster. Great defensive asset. And number 5, Josh Holland with the ball. Moving it to number 17, Eric Crosby. And a big stick fake there.
And he wants another one.
Absolutely, and, but he will get pushed behind.
Nice ground ball by Graham Archer.
Absolutely, and great recognition by Josh Holland to kind of take it out. Get some offensive sets, run in. Scores, yeah, the Westminster only down by one with 4:56 left in the third quarter. They're just going to keep grinding that clock away, make BYU's defense pay.
Well, I think the defense for Westminster definitely stepped up in the second half. Really,
what a dodge from number 5, Josh Holland. Great split dodge right there in the lefty shot to the lower corner. I mean, what would you expect from the D2 transfer?
You know, I like how he brought the his stick back into his left hand, Alex, to get a better angle on the shot. That's why he finished it right there.
Absolutely. Very quick, athletic, offensive midfielder. Again, now he brings the score being tied here, 12-all, with 4:46 left in the third quarter. Again, fans are starting to get into it now. Eager to see a big win over BYU here. Long time coming.
This would cement what... A win today, Alex, would cement Westminster's number one seed in the conference championship.
Yeah, absolutely, which is a big deal, getting that number one seed in the conference. As you said, RMLC is, you know, one of the best divisions and conferences here with some standout teams. You know, BYU, CSU, CU, Utah, Westminster, you know, all top contenders here.
Absolutely.
One of the, I believe, one of the stronger conferences in the MCLA, if not the strongest.
If not the strongest, absolutely.
After a big play by number 14 getting the ground ball off the faceoff, number 5 has the ball from behind. Look at his take his man in. Big throw in there. Number 20 with the pickup.
Eric Crosby probing the defense.
Troy Vance looking to get a dodge here and get a goal on the board. Again, 15 with the split dodge. We'll try to work his way in. But again, physical defense there by BYU. Getting a little bit chippy out there. Seems to be a failure to advance call made by the refs. Ball will go back to BYU.
Yeah, I'm not sure what there was definitely a procedure call at Alex. I'm not sure if it was a failure or what it was.
But yeah.
Just wanted to give a shout out to any Westminster alums who are currently watching the game, especially friends on the East Coast. Jeff Peters, thanks for watching.
And a nice big goal from number 20 from Westminster. Wow, what a freshman, big freshman goal right there. Get Westminster up in the league. Number 20, Christian Camper. What a beautiful shot there, too, on the left side.
Yeah, that was something that I was going to say earlier, Alex, and it's definitely pertinent right now is I'd like to see Westminster push it in transition a little bit.
Absolutely.
And maybe try to get some opportunities when they're bringing the ball up. And they capitalized on one right there.
Absolutely, and they had faith in their players, especially from a freshman who's not normally getting playing time. They trust in themselves, and they'll get those goals, and that's the real big key here for Westminster. And a big holding call here on BYU. Number 27 seems to not disagree. And the refs will turn the call over. I don't know what happened on that little exchange, but it seems that number 27 convinced the ref that it wasn't on the right call.
Yeah, I'm not totally sure what happened either, Alex, but there was definitely a change in possession. It looked almost like a delayed call and that they were calling Westminster for a push on the faceoff is what it looked like.
Absolutely, and a big missed errant pass there on BYU. And Jake Berard in some trouble trying to work with his men. And a big stop there, though, but number 24 looking to streak downfield. Noah Bloomfield. Sorry, that's number 24 on Westminster. Number 24, Brandon Royce. And number 21, Jake Arbon with the goal. Again, tough play there for Westminster, but great recognition by BYU taking advantage of, you know, the stall on the clear here for Westminster.
Clearing is so important, Alex. I think it's not one of the most important statistical category is your effective clearing percentage.
Absolutely. I mean, if you can't get the ball down on offense, then
can't score.
You're going to be stuck on defense. Your defenders are going to get tired, and it's going to be a long ball game for the West for your own team. Again, the score is all tied up, 13 all, with 1:48 left in the third quarter. Ryan Kofeld on the faceoff.
Nice ground ball, Taylor Atchison.
Yeah, another big pickup there for Taylor Atchison. Number 17, Eric Crosby. Taking a lot of stick checks there, but not phasing him. Takes a shot, though. And it'll be stopped by number 30, Dolan Hampshire. I mean, great recognition there for Eric to get it in. Just unfortunate. Ball didn't get in.
Yeah, it doesn't help when you hit the goalie in the chest, Alex.
Yeah, it does not help at all. Oh, and a big stop there. Seemed to have tipped off by number 15.
That was off blue.
And the refs, fans not happy with this one. And a flag is thrown on the field. Yeah, refs not happy with that call. I think all of them could see it was hitting off a BYU player's shoe, but refs said otherwise. Number 21, Jake Arbon with taking the ball. Shoots wide behind the back and misses. Westminster will be down, man. Seems to be a call on number 14. Didn't quite catch that call. Refs were blocking the actual play call. Okay, and Westminster looking to try and take away the possession so they can get the ball.
That's the end of the third quarter.
And, yeah, all tied up here. 13-all going into the fourth quarter for another big RMLC matchup. Again, we'll see what happens. Stay tuned here after a quick word from our sponsors, and we'll be back for some more action.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
To speed up recovery from a sprained ankle, follow the RICE treatment plan. Rest, ice, compression, and elevation. First, rest and keep weight off the ankle. Next, ice the injury for about 20 minutes at a time. Third, wrap the ankle in a compression bandage, and finally, elevate to minimize swelling. If you experience an ankle injury, see your doctor or call us.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
Proper nutrition helps athletes enhance training efforts, improve health, maintain weight, and maximize physical performance. Before and after activity, we recommend balanced nutrition, including carbohydrates, proteins, fruits, and vegetables. If you want more information on how proper nutrition can help you, see your doctor or contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
Tonight's game is brought to you by SportsMed Utah, the official sports medicine provider of Westminster College. No matter your injury or individual needs, their expert team is here for you. SportsMed Utah, proud supporters of Westminster Athletics.
And we're back here in the fourth quarter of another big RMLC matchup. Game's all tied up against BYU and Westminster. And Westminster will be man down here for the next while. Again, just physical plays are coming out after some missed calls, some players getting a little bit frustrated. Scott, what do you think? You know, what do you think about these last couple, you know, stretches of plays?
Well, I think Westminster needs to not get too high or too low.
Another
right, and just stay focused, be disciplined, stick to the game plan, and they should be able to come out on top. If they let their emotions get the best of them, they could be in for a long fourth quarter.
Absolutely, and another big shot save there for number 21, Eric Gronseth. Again, Westminster's man down defense is just stepping up big time. But the last minute goal there, number 11, Jaden Hawes with the shot and scored.
And that can often be the most dangerous time for a man up play, Alex, is when that penalty is released and the sixth man is running back into the hole. It can be easy for someone to get lost.
Absolutely, yeah, especially when everyone's trying to call numbers, get their matchups, make sure they got everyone. BYU was just continuing for every second of that penalty and did not give up to the last minute and got a great shot off. Again, the score will be 14-13, BYU with 14 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Nice lift there by number 7, Dalton Tour, letting Jake Berard get in. But the ball will get stripped here in the middle. Seems to be another failure to advance call on Westminster. Again, BYU behind, Mike Fabrizio with the ball. Number 9, taking streaking downfield, shot wide. Nick Stevens with the shot. Mike Fabrizio behind with the pickup. And number 29, shooting right into Chase Miller. It's shooting right into Eric Gronseth's stick. Another nice save there by Eric Gronseth. Big save, I think, especially in this fourth quarter.
Well, I think that's what, you know, that's what the defense wants, is they want BYU to shoot on the run, maybe fading away from the goal, from 15 yards, and they have faith in their keeper to make the save.
And another errant pass here on BYU. We'll give the ball back here to Westminster. Again, BYU's ride has been, you know, very tenacious here, but giving Westminster a lot of troubles in the clearing game.
Yeah, they haven't cleared the ball especially well today, Alex. And typically clearing is, that's a classic clear right there. Typically clearing is one of our strongest.
Big shot there from number 20, Kyle Posser, but it seems that number 30, Dolan Hampshire, was just waiting for that. Again, Kyle's getting away with a couple of shots, but goalie was ready for that one. Oh, and nice. Another big stop here. And the shot just goes wide. Kyle Posler intercepting the ball in midair, trying to put the ball in cage while the goalie was out. So BYU will have the ball again.
Should have shot that overhand, Alex.
You know, for all the kids listening here, always stick to overhand.
Overhand shots, kids.
That's where the accuracy comes in. And a big stop there.
He's calling a push.
Yeah,
like
he's calling
call.
A push on BYU. It'll go back to Westminster.
That's the right call.
Absolutely, yeah. Good call there by the refs, especially in a close game like this. Josh Holland with the ball, moving it to number 17, Eric Crosby. Again, Westminster still down by one, looking to tie the game up here with 11 minutes and 30 seconds left in the game. And Crosby loading up but faking the shot out, testing his man. Graham Archer with ball up top.
Again, just so great at probing the defense, Alex, and just seeing how they're going to play him and what they're going to do in different situations.
Yeah, absolutely. Westminster is very good, just taking that time off the clock. Recognizing they don't need to really rush, even though they're down. Oh, and another big rip there from number 17, Eric Crosby. But again, great save by number 30, Dallin Hampshire of BYU.
I'd like to see him put that on the ground, Alex.
Absolutely, yeah. I think a lot of Westminster here shooting up top high because the goalie is a little bit shorter. But again, yeah, I think the goalie's recognizing that. So maybe some low shots may mix it up, maybe get it in for them.
So far today, I haven't been keeping count, but I feel like, other than maybe Kyle Posler, when Westminster puts the ball on the ground, they're finishing.
Absolutely. Again, number 6, Mike Fabrizio behind with the ball. Mike looking to draw the extra man and pass off to his teammates.
Good defense by number 13, Nick Fuco. He is a fan favorite and a team favorite.
Absolutely, yeah. Local Judge Memorial High School kid, just only about, 30 minutes down the road here from Westminster.
His parents are very active with the team and are truly wonderful people.
Oh, and a big miss play there. 27, Joaquin Mixco on the stop. And Westminster will take the ball out.
Nice clear by Nick Fuco.
Yeah, absolutely. Way to go for Kyle Posser, being right there to help his defender out. It's one thing, you know, when you're clearing the ball, you really try to avoid is having your lawn sticks try to clear the
Get
ball
trapped.
Down. Yeah. Yeah, and it's easy pickings for all those riders. It's great recognition there by Kyle Posser again. Ball up top, number 5. Moving it to number 22, Elias Fairman. Elias Fairman been relatively quiet here on the scoreboard here. No, coming off of a big sickness here. Wasn't able to show up to practice yesterday. Was bedridden, according to his roommates.
He's a competitor, though, Alex. He wouldn't miss this.
Absolutely. No, never, especially a big game like this. Big shot wide here for Josh Holland, recovered by Westminster. Oh, and a big rip from Josh Holland with the split dodge. Man, I don't know how you can stop that kind of split dodge. He sold it, got a step on his man, and finished just perfectly.
Well, I like the shot placement on that, Alex. You know, he went off offside hip from that angle. That's a tough shot to save.
Absolutely. You know, as we were talking about before, getting those balls a little bit lower for this goalie, throwing him off. Yeah, fans down lower getting into it now. All tied up here, 14-all with 8 minutes and 31 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
It's hard not to get into it, Alex, on a beautiful spring day like this.
Yeah, absolutely, and a big matchup. BYU here with the pickup from number 55, Walker Ward. Number 9, Nick Stevens with the ball, moving it off. Number 1, Zach Jordan with the ball. Number 6, Mike Fabrizio with the ball. Going to test his freshman defender.
Good body defense right there.
Absolutely. I think that's a great personnel change up there for Westminster, getting that freshman, which is a great body defender. Big, thick kid, does not get pushed around easily. A big stop there for Eric Ronstadt by shot by number 1. And a big pass there.
I like it.
Big recognition there. A lot of great plays. Ryan Kofel, unfortunately, was looking to make the extra pass there to number 33, Thomas Sargent, but it gets tripped up.
That's the dangers of pushing it in transition, Alex. You need to move the ball quickly and play fast, but you need to make sure that you're also under control.
Absolutely. Oh, and another big stop. Eric Ronstadt just on fire right now. He's getting pretty pumped up right now, too, after a big stop like that.
We like to call those kind of saves popcorn, Alex.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, not the greatest, you know, shooting it really fast, but putting it right on the goalie stick, that's, you know, that's bread and butter for any goalie.
They just pop it up and like it's nothing and popcorn.
Yep, absolutely. Number 5, Josh Holland with the ball. Number 17, Eric Crosby up top with the ball. Throwing it back to number 5. And Josh Holland just been a real big key player here today, having some big plays. Another big shot from Josh Holland. Wow. Using his speed to get around everyone, especially a long stick defender. You know, seeing that Josh recognizing that he's probably one of the faster players out there, is not afraid to take on a long stick midfielder, puts it on the cage, and goal.
Yeah, I really, I like how he ran at his man with a lot of speed, froze his feet, ended up being able to turn his defender around, and went hard to his strong hand and finished.
Yeah, man, how much do you wish he had that kind of foot skills and all those kind of shooting skills when we were playing?
A lot, Alex. A lot.
Absolutely. Again, Westminster up by 1, 15-14, with 6 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter. And another. And the ball will go to Westminster after a big save there by Ryan Kofelt.
Some of these careless passes in transition, Alex.
Yeah, they're really gonna eat away at Westminster's gains. I think again, it's just players need to just kind of, as I see it, they're getting a little bit anxious out there, trying to make the extra play, trying to make the heroic play, but you know, it's just getting a little bit too risky out there.
Yeah, I mean, I mentioned earlier that I wanted to see them push it in transition, but it's definitely a double-edged sword, that transition game, because you can make easy turnovers like that.
Yeah, absolutely. There's just always a time for pushing it, and there's a time to just kind of take it back, get the right players on the field, give your defense a break, and put it back on the offense.
Good defense. Nice slide.
Yeah. Eric Crosby, offensive midfielder.
Nick Fuco not backing down.
Those penalties, though, can be costly, but it seems that
It may be offsetting, Alex. There might be a penalty on both teams. I'm not sure.
Yeah, we'll see here with the call.
Two flags on the field right now. They are offsetting penalties.
Offsetting.
So it will be 5-on-5.
Be interesting to see what the play calls on each side, seeing which team has more time on penalties.
Yeah, I didn't see what the penalties were.
But it seems that
I imagine probably a minute each for unnecessary roughness.
Absolutely, and I think, it seems that the ball will go to Westminster for those penalties. So it'll be interesting, a little 5-on-5 game, you know. Coaches always, I know I have Westminster here, notoriously always practicing odd man situations, not full personnel on the field.
What a split dodge.
Oh, and another big shot there on the ground for Kyle Posser, but just gets deflected from a defender.
It's going to be out of bounds.
Great pressure there from both number 15, Troy Vance, number 17, Eric Crosby. Recognize the situation.
Yeah.
Shoots and scores. Gets lit up at the end there. But gets the goal. Takes it to Westminster up by 2, 16-14.
You know, in the first half, I thought the Westminster defense had some similar mental lapses in unsettled situations, gave up some easy goals. In situations just like that, I'm glad to see Westminster get one back right there.
Absolutely. That's a huge confidence boost there, especially in the senior Eric Crosby. Just putting his team back in the game after a big scuffle like that, making his players recognize, you know, they're still in this and they can win this no matter what.
Well, how about senior captain Kyle Posler recognizing and getting set up for the quick restart and being able to find the freshman for the finish.
Absolutely.
Or senior Eric Crosby for the finish.
Absolutely. So. And I was talking to assistant coach Brad Lavoy, you know, what are his thoughts on these seniors for this year? And he said, by far, Kyle Posler is one of the smartest players he's ever coached. And that goes to show right there, when his recognition right there.
Absolutely.
Again, BYU with the pickup. Will streak down, number 27, Quentin Wiley.
Was there an illegal substitution, or the Westminster bench is losing it right now? There must have been some kind of illegal substitution. There's a flag on the field. Offsides.
Offside penalty there.
That's a technical foul, so it'll be a 30-second penalty. I'm just noticing Chris Fuco's still in the box.
Yeah, he must have been called for maybe one or more penalties. I don't know if BYU still has their player in there.
I don't see him in there. Oh that's for the offsides. So I believe they're still even at fives.
And the ball goes back to Westminster. And they're waving one off. They're waving off the offsides. Ball goes back to Westminster. So it will still be even.
Yeah, I think West...
Yeah, a lot of confusing play down there, but the refs are still trying to sort it out,
too. Still trying to sort it out.
But what the offsides did get waved off. So it is even on the field, though. So
it's even at fives. Yeah.
Eric Gronseth looking to take the time he needs. Finds that open man, number 25. Graham Archer looking for a fast break right here. And a big shot miss. And a big recovery there by Troy Vance. That was a close one. I didn't think they were going to get that. But great recognition there from the ride. Westminster, very sneaky ride package they use, throwing an extra man in there while overloading one side to kind of throw off the riding team, thinking that, oh, all the players are down here, but little do they know, sending a player from the box to get an open clear.
Here's Eric Crosby probing the defense again.
And Eric Crosby will be called in for a crease violation. Again, yes, Westminster up 16-14 with now 3 minutes to go. Looking to hold that lead and maybe add a few more up there.
This is a big possession for BYU right here, Alex. I was about to say I wouldn't be surprised if they called a timeout, and they do.
And they do. BYU takes a timeout here. We'll take a short break, and we'll be right back with after a quick word from our sponsors.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
Prevent injury and reduce knee pain by strengthening the muscles surrounding the joint. Strong muscles are your first line of protection. Start a program that gradually increases strength and conditioning to help protect the knee joints. And incorporate drills specific to your sport to keep you in game shape. If you experience a knee injury, see your doctor or contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
And we're back here for more fourth quarter action. Westminster Griffins playing BYU Cougars. Westminster up by two with 2:56 left, but BYU with possession down here. Again, it's going to get a little, I could maybe foresee a little bit more physical plays here, given that it's a close rivalry and close game. We'll see what BYU has here after taking a timeout. And a great lift check there by Tanner Duryea.
What a great hustle there by number 27, Joaquin Mixco.
Wow.
Really been the heart and soul of this Westminster program since his freshman year. Hard to find someone who cares more about his teammates in the game than number 27, Joaquin Mixco.
Absolutely. Even coming off of a big ACL tear and, you know, knowing that, you know, especially when it was his senior year, recognizing he may not be able to play, but coaches giving him that chance saying, come back and play for us. We love having you around, especially you're such a big leader on the team. And again, Joaquin Mixco proving it today that, you know, he is leading this defense out of this kind of big game. Again, Westminster taking the ball out. Troy Vance, number 15, getting doubled. And Westminster will take a timeout here, recognizing the 10-man, or West BYU pulling that goalie. So again, we'll take another quick break here from with the word from our sponsors, and we'll get right back here in with the action.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
To avoid common overuse injuries like tendonitis, incorporate a strength and conditioning program into your routine. Also, mix up your training with more than one sport. Athletes who participate in only a single sport have been found to have a higher injury rate than those athletes who cross-train. Planning a recovery week during times of heavy training can also help keep you in the game.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com. Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
To reduce your risk of injury, warm up and cool down. Tight muscles are more prone to injury and put more stress on tendons, joints, and bones. Increase flexibility and strength of muscles with a combination of stretching and conditioning exercises before and after sports play. If you want more injury prevention techniques, then please contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
And here we go. 1:57 left in the fourth quarter. Westminster with the ball, leading by two. BYU looking to pull their goalie here to try to double up the ball here to kind of get a possession in their favor. Westminster will look to get that player who has the goalie, which is in this case number 28, Kyle Posler. Oh, and a big
over
call there,
back.
Over and back there. BYU getting a little bit anxious there, trying to get a goal on the board, even throwing their defenders down there.
Defense! Defense! Defense!
And a big stop there from the defense. And another call here from the refs. Fans are not happy. Giving the ball back to BYU with 1:28 left in the game.
Well, you know,
another big shot. Zach Jordan putting BYU up by one.
I was about to say, Alex, Westminster's had some very close games this year. Some games decided in the very final seconds.
Absolutely.
On the clock. And I was going to say, I'd be surprised if this wasn't another game that came down to the very wire.
Absolutely. Big game like that against Minnesota Duluth. Westminster losing in overtime. But then another big win against CU Boulder that came down to the final minutes. Especially in that kind of a big rivalry. Westminster's been here before. They know what they're to expect, especially from BYU. We'll see who comes out here in the next minute, 23 seconds. Westminster is still up by one with 16-15. Again, huge face-off here. But pick up there from number 17 on BYU, Dustin Skuzin. And again, BYU will take the timeout, get a play up on the board, see if they can tie the game. We'll take another short break here after a word with our sponsors, and we'll be back with the action.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the Red Lion Downtown Salt Lake City, an official lodging partner of Westminster Athletics. The Red Lion Downtown, a short distance to world-class skiing.
Salt Lake Regional Physical Therapy. We treat the team and all the fans. Here's a tip on how to get back to play.
Muscle cramps are painful and can happen during activity when dehydrated and fatigued. Depending on the location of the cramp, stretch, massage, and immediately hydrate with drinks including electrolytes. If the cramping continues, stop activity and see your doctor or contact us.
So get back to play and go to saltlakeregional.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back here. 1 minute left to go. BYU with the ball. Westminster up by one. A huge key matchup here. And a big missed pass there by BYU. BYU will turn it over. The ball will go back to Westminster. With 56 seconds left and up by one.
Yeah, that was a huge mistake by BYU.
Huge mistake. That may cost
them. Crucial clear now for Westminster.
Absolutely. Westminster will look to take the time they need, not make any mistakes.
Should probably just bomb it into the box.
Absolutely. This time you throw it into Coffin Corner, which he will do. And a great stop there by Troy Vance. Left. And the ball's up. 12 seconds.
Oh, my gosh.
On a big push. Will the refs throw the flag? No, they hold the flag. 3-2-1. Westminster beats BYU the first time in history.
First time in team history. BYU has lost to an in-state team. They have never been beaten by another team from the state of Utah. That was the first time. Westminster handing them their first loss, 16-15.
Holy cow, what a hell of a game here. Wow, came down to the wire, but Westminster pulls through with several key plays. Big stop on defense. And the fans here come to take in the Westminster Griffins after a huge win. Again, folks, thanks for coming out and watching a huge key game here. We look forward to seeing Westminster on the road, going to conference and nationals. Stay tuned. We'll hope to see Westminster going to take the national title in the future. Thanks again, everyone. See you soon.
Tonight's game is brought to you by The Courtyard by Marriott, an official lodging partner.